New Doxa Church, I'm speaking to you this Wednesday morning from a very cold property here at our new property. And I think we are all aware of what's going on in South Africa at this stage with lockdown, with COVID, and with all the things that are happening in our provinces and the burning and the looting and a bunch of stuff that's going on at this stage. And I want to remind you of a word that I brought to our church at the end of last year, that God has the final say. God has the final say. And I think it's more important now more than ever that we are reminded of that reality. Not governments, not people groups, not ideologies, but God has the final say in our lives, on this earth and in our country and in South Africa. You see, the reality is not just in Genesis, but that God have the first day, let there be light, and there was light. We have to take our cue from that. If God says something, it is. And we can, and I know there are many people that are upset, that are angered, that are driven to many, many things, that are looking to countries where we can immigrate and all the things that go around there. But I want to remind you today, not just in Genesis, but also in Revelation, God has the final say. If God says something, it is done. And I want to remind you of that reality. I think sometimes we forget the greatness of who God is and that He truly rules and that He reigns. And I want to remind you, this daily devotion is not going to be long. It is to remind us as a church that God has the final say, not the president, not political parties or ideology, but God has the final say. And some of us need to hear this reality today. We are filled with fear and uncertainty and even anger at what we see around us. But let me tell you something. There are many women and men and children, followers of Jesus Christ, that are calling out to God, black, white, colored, Indian, the whole spectrum of people that are calling out to God in South Africa today. And you know what? God hears our prayers. He sees what is going on. And I want to remind you today of this reality, that God has the final say. No matter how dire the situation might look, God has the final say. Because I've learned this in my life. Every storm, doesn't matter how intense, how bad, and how crazy it gets, every storm runs out of rain. Every storm runs out of rain. Eventually, it will finish because God has the final say. Hold on to this reality today. You and your family, wherever you find yourself in South Africa, send this video to somebody if they might need it. God has the final say because He still is the ultimate ruler. There is no one above Him. He has the final say in our country. Let's pray together in Jesus' name. Father, thank you for every man, woman, and child and family scattered all around South Africa. Churches that are praying together. And Father, thank you that you hear our cries. And Father, I pray for the peace, your peace, the shalom peace, the perfect rest of God to descend on this country in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, that your calm will descend in people's lives, that calm will return to our country. Lord, you are the ruler of South Africa. You are the God of your people. And Father, thank you that you have the final say. We can stand on that reality, irrespective of what's going on around us and the uncertainty and the anger of the situation. You have the final say. We hold on to this reality in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hear this word. God has the final say. In Jesus' name. Bye.